take some time to realize. But if you look inside, I'm sure you'll find. Over your shoulder, you know that I told you I'll always be picking you up when you're down. So just turn around.
Welcome back to this week's episode of CTV.
Let's check out a Play It Forward recap.
This week for CTV, we went to check out the Play It Forward tournament, part 2.
Let's check it out.
I'm here with the winning team, the Blood Brothers. How's it feel to win?
It's no big deal. I mean, it was bound to happen. So, yeah.
What do you have to say to the next opponent?
Eat up. We're coming.
Now, who's the best player on your guys' team?
I mean, team captain right here, obviously.
Thank you and good luck. I'm here with the losing team, the Glacier Freezes. Why'd you guys lose?
Because Alex is a terrible line judge and Camden is just too good at volleyball.
Who's your guys' best player?
Probably Ellen Amira.
Thank you. I'm here with the losing team, the Freezer Tarps. Why'd you guys lose?
All right, well, personally, Andy, I think it was kind of crud that we lost. They had two players who were not rostered on the team, and they played, and the official, Caleb Hine, might have not given us a lot of calls that should have been our calls.
Who was the best player on your team?
Me. Not even a question. It was me. Everything I do, I'm always the best. Nobody's better than me.
I'd have to back that up. That's true.
Debatable. Thank you. I'm here with the winning team, the Out of the World team. How's it feel to win?
Absolutely amazing.
Who's your guys' best player?
Definitely Cameron Hovind.
No, good luck to you guys. I'm here with the second place team, the Blood Brothers. How's it feel to get second place in the whole tournament?
You know, it doesn't feel very good, but it was nice coming close to the seniors. I don't know if we really had a chance to make it all the way to the finals, but, you know, stuff happens.
Are you mad about the loss?
You know, I just wanted to win for the pizza, but it's okay, I guess.
Good job, guys. I'm here with the first place team, the Out of This World team. How's it feel to beat little kids?
It feels pretty great. We're all pretty competitive, so we were planning on winning anyway.
Yeah, I'm sure. Thank you.
I'm here with Patrick and Lauren, and what was the Play It Forward tournament about?
We just wanted to get some engagement in the school before Thanksgiving break. Have some fun during flex, stuff like that.
And where did all the proceeds go?
The proceeds went to Share, and they give Thanksgiving meals to the less fortunate families and Christmas presents to less fortunate families.
That's very thoughtful. Now back to the nest.
Congrats, Cam, and the rest of the seniors.
Now let's check out sports.
Welcome back to another week of
amazing, gorgeous, exciting
sports. Check it out.
The Laverne boys hockey team traveled to Marshall last week to play the Tigers on their own ice. There, they beat them 5-3. Brock Barron would have 2 goals, Owen Sungay would have 2 goals, and Maddox Damagala would have 1.
Then the girls hosted the Tigers here in Laverne. The girls would have put them away, beating them 3-0. Peyton Bear had 2 goals, and Cameron Van Potato 1.
Gymnastics started their season off hot with a win over Blue Earth. They scored 126-119. Ella Reisdorfer and Amira Cowell would be leading the Cardinals.
Laverne fell short and lost 77-45 to Southwest Christian last week Thursday. Gavin DeBeer scored 17 points, Carter's Hare finished with 12 points, and Gannon Arndt ended with 11 points.
That same night, the girls would end up earning a victory over Southwest Christian Eagles 65-39. In this game, Elizabeth Wagner scored 21 points, Christina Wagner had 12, and Sarah Stuganga ended the night with 8 points.
Wrestling had their first tournament over the weekend. Team placed first overall as a team with everyone placing, getting first in the weight class in the tournament with DJ Rock and Leif Ingerbritsen. Getting second in the weight class was Bernie Matthew, Jen, and Sam.
Great job to all the winter sports this week. And now,
back to the nest.
Looks like winter sports are off to a great start.
Now let's go check out some of our great seniors.
This week for CTV, we checked out Senior Spotlight.
Check it out.
Andy's our first senior this week, and Andy, what is your favorite animal?
A dog.
What's your favorite high school memory?
Winning my senior year, Battle Axe.
What's your favorite holiday?
Christmas.
And what are your future plans?
I plan to attend Mankato State University for sports management.
Thank you. Christina is our second senior this week, and Christina, what's your favorite ice cream?
Chocolate.
What's your favorite high school memory?
Homecoming of this year.
What would you do if you won the lottery?
Go on a shopping spree.
And what are your future plans for after high school?
I plan on attending SMSU for business communications and play basketball.
Thank you.
Austin is our third senior this week. Austin, who's your favorite teacher?
Daryl Van Artsen.
What's your favorite high school memory?
Construction class.
What's your favorite tool in your tool belt right now?
Probably the square.
What are your future plans?
Go to Southeast Tech in Sioux Falls and work at Titan Machinery as a diesel mechanic.
Thank you.
Anya's our fourth senior this week, and Anya, what's your favorite type of ice cream?
Cookies and cream.
What's your favorite high school memory?
Senior homecoming.
What's your favorite holiday?
Christmas.
And what are your future plans?
I'm going to go to the University of Northwestern and play volleyball.
Thank you.
Good luck with your future plans, seniors.
Back to the nest.
Thanks, seniors.
Now let's go check out a headphone challenge with Gavin, Marcus, and Brock.
This week on CTV, we checked out how well people can read lips. Let's check it out.
I like to eat soggy pancakes.
Say it again.
I like to eat soggy pancakes.
Alex is...
I like to eat soggy pancakes.
I like eating.
I like to eat soggy pancakes.
I like I like to eat dog treats. Soup. I like to eat
soggy pancakes. Pancakes.
Bananas?
Pan.
Bread.
No. Pancakes.
Baguettes? You don't eat tables. Breakfast.
Pancakes.
Like.
Pancakes.
Yeah! What are you having for dinner tonight?
What are the colors of the rainbow?
What are you having for dinner tonight?
What are the animals? I don't know.
What are you having for dinner tonight?
What are you having for lunch? Dinner. Supper. Breakfast.
What are you having for dinner tonight?
What am I having for dinner tonight?
Yo.
Good job, everyone.
Back to the nest.
Nice guessing, guys.
Now let's go check out the upcoming FFA breakfast.
This week on CTV, we went to check out the FFA breakfast feed.
Check it out.
We are here with...
Marin.
Okay, and we are going to ask about the FFA food banquet. So when is the FFA food banquet?
December 19th.
Where is it?
American Reformed Church.
What time does it start?
We're going to start serving food at 6:30.
Why do you do it?
So basically it is just so the FFA can have a little bit of extra money if we decide to buy something throughout the year.
What's different about this year than last year?
This year we're going to do takeout containers so then more kids can hopefully come and have some pancakes.
Thank you.
Yep. We are here with
Julia.
And I was just wondering, when is the FFA breakfast feed and what are you guys providing?
It is on December 19th, and we are providing egg bake, scrambled eggs,
sausage, bacon, we're doing pancakes. There's a whole bunch of different food we're doing.
Perfect. And then are you guys providing drinks or no?
We are. I think we're doing orange juice, of course milk, and I think we're doing some juices as well.
Perfect. Thank you.
No problem.
And that is all. Back to the nest.
Let's make sure we all go to the FFA breakfast.
See you next week.